Welcome back to the Island 54 Devlog. Today, I'll show you my initial attempt at drag and drop inventory management. Last week, I simplified the player controls a little and had Sally playtest my game. Something I already knew, but that the playtest reinforced, was that I needed to improve my inventory management. Now, I didn't get nearly as much done this week as I'd hoped, because I spent much of the week recovering from COVID and helping homeschool our kids. But I'll give you an overview of how I implemented drag and drop, while also showing you how it looks so far. Then I'll talk about what's missing and how I'll go about finishing it off. As always, I've included chapter marks and timestamps down in the description below. My first use case was the ability to drag between different inventory slots, so I focused on that. I wrote interfaces to be placed on game objects that can be the source of a drag and the target of a drop, respectively. I wrote a class called ItemsDragSystem to manage the drag and drop of inventory slots. When a drag starts, it keeps a record of the source of that drag operation and the actual items that are being dragged. We record these separately so that we can later modify how much of a stack is brought across. We invoke an event so that other components can tell what's being dragged and update themselves accordingly. This allows us to update the cursor with an image of the dragged items. Whenever the mouse moves during a drag, we fire off another event, allowing the image of the dragged items to follow the cursor. Lastly, when the drag operation completes, we check if it was dropped onto a valid drop target and try moving the inventory around. If there's space for the dragged items in the target slot, then we transfer the items directly there. Alternatively, we consider trying to swap the contents of the source and target slots. The drop target interface just allows a component to nominate which inventory slot it's associated with, so that that slot can receive items. The drag source interface has the same slot property and also implements Unity's drag and drop interfaces. C# lets you put default implementations on interfaces, allowing you to define something like a mixin class. Any component implementing this interface will automatically forward the drag and drop events through to the items drag system without the need for any boilerplate code. For now, the inventory slot UI needs to implement both the drag source and drop target interfaces. It already defined a slot property, so no further changes were needed beyond declaring that we implement the interfaces. Trying it out, this felt pretty good to use, and even felt more realistic than the previous method of having to put items down to swap them between your hands. I wanted to be able to drag items to and from the world too. I had a look at some of my similar code and realized I was overdue for a refactor of my inventory and item instantiation code. I have multiple pieces of code responsible for adding and removing items from the world, and anytime an item could be placed in either an inventory slot or the real world, I end up with further duplication. I knew I was cutting it fine to get this episode out on time, so I focused instead on making the land claim inventory draggable. The existing land claim code searched the claim area for its items, grouped them, and reconfigured the UI on every frame. Because the claim inventory reused the inventory slot UI, the drag and drop code already tries adding and removing items from those slots too. All I had to do was detect the attempt to change the contents of those slots from the drag and drop operation and realize those changes within the world. I calculate how many items have been added or removed, then either add or remove those game objects. I ended up skipping over the instantiation code because it was going to be replicating the drop and harvest code, so I'd rather put my effort into refactoring than implementing the same thing a third time. And that's when I ran out of time for this episode. So I tried out the bits of the land claim dragging I had and was pretty happy with the results. It's a bit rough around the edges and has a bug where picking up an item from the land claim causes two items to be destroyed. I immediately knew this was because the event listener destroying items on behalf of the drag and drop system can't tell if an item was removed by the drag and drop system or via the old pickup command. So there's a lot I didn't get time to finish this week. It should be possible to drag items directly from the viewport into an inventory slot, and from an inventory slot into the viewport. I also want to be able to drag partial stacks of items. If you're carrying a stack of items, maybe you only want to put half of them down. This could be achieved with a mouse scroll wheel, but because it's clunky to use while dragging, I'd also like a middle button click to initiate a drag. I'm wondering if an inventory window like the claim inventory might be useful to have always available, but make the claim inventory allow a greater range, for example. Once I've refactored the item system, this will be a lot easier to implement. The refactor is becoming pretty urgent at this point, so I'll likely be working on that as this video comes out. I'll likely change things so that there's a link between instantiated items in the world and the voxel they're attached to. Each voxel then becomes something similar to an inventory. Comment of the week this week is from Psycho Twitch, who asks if I'm basing my game on Worm. One of the funny things about publishing this devlog is that I'm finding out how little I know about other crafting and survival games. My main inspiration for my game are Eve for its economics, EverQuest for its combat loop and fantasy setting, and a lesser-known game called A Tale in the Desert for crafting. Beyond that, I'm likely to take little ideas from other games and media. For example, I'll take some elements of the food system from Valheim. For the magic system, I'll likely be inspired by a number of videos by a YouTuber and author named Shad Brooks. That wraps it up for this week's episode. I'm mostly feeling better now, so hope to get through a bit more next week. As always, if you enjoyed this episode, don't forget to leave a like. And if you didn't enjoy it but watched the end anyway, be sure to leave a mean comment down below. And until next time, happy game developing.